amount of time, if we ever do that, along with a copy of the chart and things like that. So we'll follow all those guidelines and rules.
I wonder if it might not be sufficient if we phrase the language on the agenda correctly, that that by itself might be a specific enough authority to then craft a letter.
That's a good idea.
Taking action on the specific rule to allow.
For clarification, what the board would be doing is directing council to craft a letter authorizing this waiver? Is that what I'm hearing?
Well, he was kind of going the opposite direction, saying that we word the agenda item in a way that, when you adopt the consent agenda, you are approving the.
Right, and then we could do the letter.
Okay.
Now, that seems clear.
Based on the request before, this is what we're going to put on the consent agenda, that we're in agreement to this, and then.
That we do not object to the reduced staffing of the West Valley Fire District.
Right, so we'll make sure that appropriate language gets onto the consent agenda.
And with the appropriate language, then everybody's comfortable with it going on the consent agenda.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Very good.
Thanks for waiting. Appreciate it.
So are you going back down the valley now, or are you just going to go home?
No, I'm going to Willamina, riding the bike.
Such a long drive. Tell your wife hello.
Thanks, Chief.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chief.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks for coming.
Okay. And the last item that I have in my folder is the item that we discussed in our economic development meeting last week.
Excuse me, Commissioner, I see two other items.
I'm sorry.
I see a request from planning to appoint three members to the planning commission. Is there a letter in the folder?
Wasn't that the one from YCSW?
SWAT. No, there's another one regarding the planning commission.
Ah, so, see, they got hooked to my, all right. Yes, this is to advise you that the terms of three current planning commissioners, Michael Sherwood, Matt Dunkel, and Marjorie Erai, are set to expire July 1, 2017. I have communicated with all three of them. They all indicate they would like to continue to serve the Planning Commission. The board is inclined action should be taken to renew their respective terms. The next Planning Commission hearing is set for July 6, 2017. So your action should take place before that date. And that would be approving the extension or reappointment of those three Planning Commissioners.
Long-term members.
Long-term members, and they're willing to continue to do it. So with no opposition, I will put this on the consent agenda.
I think, Laura. A doubling of their current salary, isn't it?
Yes.
At least double. Depends on what the compensation committee decides.
Yes. And then we have also one other item, and that was the resolution that we pulled off last week. It's in the matter of a resolution in support of the Stepping Up initiative. And I can read that today, or I can read it at the formal hearing. Either way, it has to be read before we actually.
Well, unless Commissioner Starrett has an objection, I'll just read it at the formal.
Yeah, that would be great. And I did look over it, and I had
everything. You're okay. Okay. So we will bring this up and move forward with it on Thursday, and I'll do the reading for the record on Thursday.
So it'd be a separate item, not on the consent agenda,
but on an additional item agenda. And okay, this we already did, so that's done. All right. Thank you, guys.
Your final two items.
Down to my final two items.
There's the economic development strategy, and then I have a final additional budget change to go over with you for the 17-18 budget.
Okay, did I have 16?
Yes,
I have that last item. Yes, thank you very much. Yes, I do have it. So first off, And Jody's here. I'm assuming that she got word that this was going to be on the agenda, but
Jody just knows.
Knows such things. But anyway, for those who are not aware, Jody was responsible, if you will, for organizing a report called the Grow Report that was commissioned by the county commissioners 3 years ago and 4 years ago.
5 years ago.
Is it? Oh, 12. Five, and it was completed 4 years ago. That's what it was. Anyway, this is a report on an economic development program, or at least the needs analysis, an analysis of what the current inventories were, an analysis of what we had to offer to move forward. And part of this, there was an executive summary that outlined some significant steps that would be initial to moving forward with economic development. And so as part of our budgeting process, our budget committee said they would like to be involved in helping us craft an economic development model moving forward. So we have had two meetings with our budget committee and all three commissioners. And part of that, we determined it would make sense at this point in time, because of the long list of participants in the GROW report that represented every corner of our county, all of our cities, and key stakeholders, that it would make sense then to review that. And we took from that this executive summary and outlined specifics within that that we're going to fold into a county economic development strategy. So with that, then we wanted to memorialize that in a session so that this would become a part of our economic development policy and program. So that is the purpose of that being here. To what extent do we need to take action on this? Do we want to make this a...
Well, if I could just briefly review with you what I did, because you had asked Carrie and I to collapse the four strategies into two.
Correct.
And so that's what we did. And what I just handed out to you are the original four strategies. And so we took strategy two and three, mm-hmm. and collapsed strategy one and four into two and three. And so you'll see I've highlighted areas in strategy one, mm-hmm. and strategy four. And those are the aspects of those two strategies that we incorporated into strategy two and three. And then I have one goal and objective in strategy two that I omitted. And so I wanted you to see in the old version what we incorporated. And I put in your boxes last week the new strategies two and three. And that was really just meant to be a starting point for you, for your discussion. I've tried to focus on the things, knowing your discussion with the last two meetings with the budget committee members, and just what you've been working on the past few years, the efforts you've made reaching out to the community, and where you've been focusing your efforts, knowing that you'll probably be looking at hiring a firm or a person to do outreach for you in the future, wanting something to be realistic and feasible, not wanting to spread your efforts too thin. I tried to focus the strategies around something that was achievable and not too diluted. And so that was the basis for my thinking in the strategies that I gave you. And so really, I just gave you a set of strategies in what I put in your boxes for you to look at to see if that was something you would be satisfied with.
Yeah, I love the strategy. I think you did it.
guys did an excellent job on the strategies. What I'm really interested now is how we can, take these strategies and put them together with the overarching mission goal that came out of the same document, so we end up with something that's just one, I don't know, six pages.
Well, I just want.
What we can do is, what I put in your box was the executive summary, and which did include the vision, mission, and values. And if you wanted us to, we could, you know, we could take the vision, mission, values, and the strategies and just include that in a document that you could include in a RFQ or an RFP to see what kind of response back you might get.
And that's kind of what I was thinking, if we can wrap everything together so we have a document here that when we, however we do it, or we go out with an RFP, you know, however we do it, we could say, here's what we're looking at, base everything we do off this.
That's what I'm just hoping. What we're talking about is crafting a guiding principle document. This is what's going to guide us in the work we're doing in economic development. This is what's going to guide us as we develop a strategy for working with our existing partners and any new partners we bring on board. But this is kind of the where we're going to look to see how does that meet with our strategies and our desire as far as development tools.
And I think you want to include some of the data in the executive strategy because it informs about the county. You know, they did an excellent job of identifying the strengths and weaknesses and what areas, you know, are important to the county, the business areas. And so I think that's information that any firm or company bidding for the services would want to know.
Yeah, and I think Jody put it well. I think the first time she was here in front of us when we talked about this is that anybody would be, whether it be MEDP or anybody else, would be hesitant to really bid on a manager project if you don't know what the project is all about yet. And the county is us, as a board of elected officials and staff, if we haven't determined what we really want. Once we determine what we really want, then it's pretty easy for anybody else to take that as an RFP and put together what was. So,
I think as we discussed in our economic development meeting, that this, we have narrowed it down. I think you did a great job crafting our ideas in that, Laura. And so we will use that then, and I don't know if we have to actually take a...
I want something finalized and said, this is what we're going to do. I just don't want, well, we should do this. I would personally have something that rather says, how somehow we memorialize it. I don't care how we memorialize it, because we can always change it afterwards. But I really want something that's a little bit more formal, that has memorialized.
We can just state it that we are now crafting the document that we've got before us is what we're going to use as our guiding principles.
And when it's done, we'll approve it.
And when we, well, and this, I hope it's never done, because we're going to be in a process of
development. The original strategy and everything has to be, you have to have a firm place to start from. Yeah, we might modify it later. But I want something we start with that's been approved.
I don't want to make it so cut and dry that that's where you stop. That's why I just want it to be a living document is what we want. We want something that we're using to guide us as we make decisions moving forward in our economic development. And I think that the information that's encapsulated in this document is really the base that we're going to build from. I think we've already decided that. But We certainly, it's up to my fellow commissioners, but I don't know how you would say this defines who we are in economic development in just one document, because I don't...
Oh, no, I think, but what this can do is say, this is what our philosophies, and this is what our vision is. Now, and that can be then finalized in a 10-page document that we now have, and anytime after we want to revise it, we can revise it. But I like a zero standing point, that there's no ambiguity with what we say we're going to do and what we may do right off the bat. But that's just so.
And I think that economic development is a world that is ever fascinating. And there are so many things that limit where you can go, so many things that could change the direction you're going. I'm just a little bit leery of setting it so firmly in concrete that it doesn't give us the flexibility. I think to have it as a guiding principle, to me, that's what I'd like to see us. We can take the, at least the executive summary of the GROW report and say, this is how we're, this is the basis for building our economic development program moving forward. And that gives us a place to go back to and see how what we decide to do matches what we said was our guiding principles. Obviously, I don't think we're ready then to do a specific agenda item with this. Sounds to me like we're still...
Well, I thought we were working to where we would have is something that we could have formally as a board approve. Not that it couldn't be changed, but formally as a board we could approve. So when we wanted to do a RFP or whatever, we had something that we can give to everybody, says here's what the board officially approved, now you base your RFP on this, and not, and I think the chair is right, economic development's never gonna stop. There will be changes to it, but I think we have, I personally think we have to have a document that says this is what we've approved. Like when I read the GROW study, I think GROW was great, I never even knew it wasn't even approved. So we need, to me, we need something formally as a board, as government, as elected officials need, so we can move forward, we need something to approve, so we can go.
Well, why don't we do this, and we've got all these documents in front of us. Why don't we reveal them, we'll put these as an additional item, it won't be a consent agenda item, and we can discuss it further, we can all look at it and see if we can put our heads together, or do you want to put it?
I'd like to see staff, Laura. I don't want to put it in.
Well, yeah, I thought that was this document.
Yeah.
I did too.
But
is it not?
Not if we say we're setting that as our, this is our absolute strategy for economic development, because I'm not comfortable with that. I think that's going to change. Again, if we do hire somebody to drive our economic development, we're going to be working with them. This can be the guiding document in how we go about hiring that person. These are the principles that we want to incorporate, but we're hiring them to come in and give us some leadership and guidance and work with our partners, and I don't want to stifle them or put handcuffs on them by saying, but you have to do it our way. I don't think that's what we want. At least for me, that would not be the way I would want to direct the company that I hired to do that specific thing. Now, we can use this as our guiding principles in developing an RFP. We can sit down with anybody who responds and say, these are the key points for us, and this is what we want to see. How would you expand this? How would you work with this? But at this point in time, I wouldn't be comfortable saying, this is what our
development is.
I've been trying very hard to interject my thoughts.
Well, you can interject now. I notice you have a lot of thoughts.
It's been difficult. Let me just say that.
Commissioner Sterrett?
Let me say that what we had asked our administrator to do was to take a look at the GROW report, to take a look at some of the information that the Budget Committee weighed in on, and to condense it into something that would be, would sort of be the template for what we thought going forward we wanted this new entity that we hired to help us with. And my understanding was is that this is what we had asked this document to signify. And I think it pretty much embodies everything that the Budget Committee and the Commissioners have talked about as far as not having us be the last word in picking and choosing who got the grant money for the video lottery money. So my understanding was that we were going to take this information and that our video lottery dollars were going to basically support the effort to hire whoever we decided to hire to do that, and also to have that other entity which would contain the people who worked on this GROW report perhaps as another
resource.
Yeah. So I don't see the purpose of kicking this down the road anymore and looking at it, parsing it, tearing it apart. We've done that, and we've done it to death. And this thing has sat on the shelf for years at great expense to a lot of people, and I think it's time for us to get off the dime and to acknowledge that this is where we want to go. And with this being said, this embodies what we all believe, then we can hand it to, for an RFQ or an RFP, to somebody who can say, all right, now come up with the ideas. This is the basic philosophy. I don't see what more we could possibly want.
Yeah, you know, and I guess the only thing that Mary that got me in that, and I agree 100% the way that you said it. If we just call it, I mean, if it was just a, I don't know what we'll call it, final report, but this is to me, I guess what threw me off, it says action plan. It is more than action plan. It's our guiding, this part then is our guiding documents of what we're looking for. It's not necessarily the action that we've taken. So that being said, this document is probably very good just to say, these are our philosophies for economic development, period. And then let them go through the goals and the objectives.
And flesh it out and say,
flesh it all out.
How does this translate into a concrete plan?
Yeah, and then they can use the GROW plan for any research they need. Use it however. So
what do you want to call it? Action plan, guiding principles, basic economic tool.
I don't think it matters
tool.
What we call it. I think we're just playing with words here.
I
it's
did
not
too.
Moving
yeah.
it further down.
But I don't want to. I
no,
don't want to restrict us in what we're doing. So I don't want to hire a company and then tell them they can't do anything but what we told them in this.
But
document.
We didn't tell them anything.
No, we told them this is what we want to do.
But there's nothing in here that specifically shows what we want to do. Nothing is restrictive here.
No. This
is pretty broad. Right.
We are going to use this document that's been provided to us by staff as the basis for a request for proposal or request for qualifications.
I thought that was the reason why we were going through this exercise.
Okay.
I think there were several reasons. The reason you just brought up, I think, is the biggest reason, Commissioner, to go through this is to give this to somebody that can do what they do. Because unlike you, I don't want to be a winner. I don't want to pick the winners. No matter what, I don't want to pick them. So, okay. So, Laura, does that kind of tell you what?
Yes.
I mean,
and if I have other questions, I may circle back
so
to you.
So, on our agenda for Thursday, you're going to have written it out so that it's clear and simple. We can all agree.
Yes. I'll think of a sentence.
She always does.
We can all concur with.
I have one more item before you adjourn.
Oh, that's right. You've got that budget item.
We did discover one more budget change that needs to be made. We thought that the assessment and taxation software project would be completely spent out by this fiscal year, but it is not. There are going to be expenditures next fiscal year, and so we need to adjust the beginning balance for the software reserve by adding $365,501 to the beginning balance and adding that same amount to the assessment and taxation software line in the software reserve. So we'd ask you to approve that budget adjustment in a 17-18 budget.
And that's for additional
training and
training. That was part of the original.
And I would just clarify, it's not necessarily additional. This is what remains of the funds that they had budgeted this year
in
software
of,
reserve. And we haven't. There, some of the milestones they're hitting or invoicing hasn't happened yet, and so originally Derek, when we were first building this budget, thought we were going to be these funds expended before the end of
well,
this
we,
budget year.
We have retained
so it really has
for
nothing
some
to
of
do
the
with costing
payments.
This.
Right.
And because those retainages haven't been paid out yet.
Okay. Right.
So it has nothing to do with costing us more.
No.
It's just costing us more, it's
timeline.
We
that's a big difference.
Money there, and we need to have have the authority to expend those dollars.
Exactly.
Yes, that's a big difference.
Thank you for the clarification.
Thank you.
The money is in the budget, it's just the retainage hasn't been paid out and won't be paid out until next fiscal year.
Got it.
With that, I don't want to have Commissioner Sterrett speeding on our highways. She needs to get in her car and get to Salem.
You just have to take her.
You're going to Salem, right?
I'm going to Salem.
I'm going to follow you.
You just have to take her.
I'll be there yesterday.
You have to be there before, my meeting's not till 3:30. Yours is at 3 o'clock.
Well, mine, I thought was at 3, Silas just told me it's at 3:30, so.
Well, gee, you can make it over there in 10 minutes if she rides.
That's right.
If you're following me, you got no problem.
I'll be there in no time.
Trying to keep up with you.
Okay, is there anything else that we need to do this afternoon before we adjourn? We've had a full meeting and I do appreciate everybody's input.
I'm sorry, there's one conference call on it.
But.
No, that's all right. We already approved your stuff.
Thank you.
So we're waiting for him to show up in front of the house.
Yeah, I wish that.
With that, we will adjourn this informal meeting of the Annual Planning Board of Commissioners for this June 20th, 2017. Thank you very much.
Cynthia, here's a question for you.